The chairperson of the Parliamentary Committee on Health, Dr. Charles Ayume, revealed that the National Medical Stores has received the funds they were asking for to buy drugs.
The government, through National Medical Stores, is trying to do whatever it can to get drugs to all parts of the country. But that is not enough. We should not have knee-jerk reactions. We should have a seamless flow of a supply chain that nobody even notices that there are bumps.
Dr. Ayume, however, condemned those who politicize health matters and also said they would investigate drug expiration.
Now, I must say that when we talk about stockouts, there's also a criteria we use. They are tracer drugs. And maybe civil society, we also need to, when we go out to the field, we need to interrogate further. What drug is not there for us to press the alarm bells? Is it ivermectin? Because there's a basket of 5 essential medicines, and there are 41, which we call the 41 tracer items. Laboratory supplies, ARVs.
We would recommend that government gives more priority to health sector financing to avoid such problems. Most of the heads of the regional referral hospitals are complaining that when they send their demands or lists for the drugs they need to national drug store, they end up getting like 50% or even a quarter of what they have requested for.
This issue of essential medicines and health supplies is definitely a constitutional issue. Under our same constitution in Uganda, the state has the obligation to ensure provision of basic medical services to the population. And indeed, essential medicines and health supplies are part of essential basic health services.
Reports by Jaliet Namoya for the news.